Hi, this is Asing. You are now watching Asing Math TV. In this video, we will learn how to obtain the p-value of a chi-square distribution. Before we are able to obtain the p-value, we have to learn how to obtain the cumulative probability distribution. We have to bear in mind that there are two cases. One is when the degrees of freedom is an odd number. One is when it is even number. We just have to make use of the lower incomplete gamma function as the numerator by using the function here. Replace t by using alphabet x. Make use of the integration function. So we have alphabet x to the power. Bracket is very important for this kind of calculator. And followed by k over 2 minus 1. K is the degree of freedom. For this case is 25 over 2 minus 1. Close bracket. And we times shift ln to get e to the power. We can put bracket before negative x. Close bracket followed by comma, and we have the lower limit, which is 0, comma followed by the upper limit x over 2. X is the critical value. For this case is 40.646. remember to take over 2, as we can see here. Then we press equal. Before we proceed to the denominator, remember to store this answer in A, so that we can recall this value and we don't have to memorize or type again this value. Now proceed to the denominator. We have k over 2, k which is 25 divided by 2, we have 12.5, and the function stated here is 1 over 2 plus n, which means that we have to remove 0.5 or 1 over 2 before we have n. So remove 0.5, which means that n is equal to 12. So by using the function, we have 2 times 12, the whole thing factorial, and we divide 4 to the power of n, which is 12 times 12 factorial, and we times square root of I, and we should obtain the value, and now we should store this value in B. So we already store the value in A and B respectively for the numerator and denominator. So to obtain the cumulative probability distribution, we just have to simply take A divided by B, and we will obtain the value. For this case, it's being rounded to the nearest 4 decimal places. And to obtain the p-value, we just have to take 1 minus answer. And we should obtain the correct value, as we can see here, which is already rounded to the nearest 4 decimal places. Now, let's try for even numbers. So, also the same, make use of the lower incomplete gamma function. So, we make use of the integration function. Now, we have alphabet x power again. Bracket is very important. So, for this case, k is equal to 8. So we have 8 over 2 minus 1, close bracket, and we times shift ln to get e power, bracket negative x, close bracket, put comma before we have the lower limit 0, comma upper limit x over 2x. For this case, the critical value is 18.412. Remember to take over 2, and we press equal. So this is the value for the numerator. So again, we store the answer in A. Now proceed to the denominator. Since this is even number, so which means that we are going to make use of this case, this function, then we just have to take k, which is 8 divided by 2, and we take minus 1. So which means that we just have to take 3 factorial, and we obtain, which is equal to 6. So the value that we store in A divide 6, and we should obtain the cumulative probability distribution. So what we have to do here to obtain p value, 1 minus the answer that we obtain. So we obtain the correct p value. And then with that, okay, that's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope you like this. See you.